Yeah, just recording has started. Okay, I think in the previous, just 5 minutes back, we need to do some modification here. Huh? See, what we have said here that earlier we have said that it is V output minimum should be less than equal to the threshold voltage, right? But the question is, should it be V out minimum or V output maximum? The V output minimum is what? V output minimum is the minimum output value of this, right? That minimum value we really cannot say from here, right? The criteria should be this V output maximum, right? I think you have made a point, but we have considered it not from that point of view. We have considered it from this point of view that this
Sir.
V output minimum means V output this minimum, right? But I think what you are trying to say that this V output minimum, the minimum value of this V output minimum, if I have written it like this, then it would have been wrong. So I should have means written it in this way. V output minimum and its maximum value of this V output minimum should be this. But by saying this term, we wanted to mean the minimum value means this value. This value should be less than this.
Sir, can it not just be replaced with VOL?
Can it not just be replaced by VOL? Yes, it can be. You are very right. It can be replaced with VOL. VOL or VOL dash? Which one?
VOL, not VOL dash.
Why not VOL dash? You
VOL dash
see,
will be zero, right?
no,
Minimum value of
no,
minimum.
no, no. That's what I'm saying. For resistive load, when
Sir,
you have a
VOL
resistive
dash.
load, you will never get, you will never reach to 0 volt. So it will be the minimum value when the input is VDD. So it will be VOL dash from our definition. Right. So you can also write VOL dash this. Ashik, is it clear to you now?
Sir, I
Sir, shouldn't it be
VOL.
VOL? Because VOL dash would be the minimum of the V out minimum,
Yes,
right?
sir.
Minimum of V output minimum is when? Minimum of V
VOL
output
dash,
minimum
so
when you have given the input VDD. So here only we are giving the minimum logic one. So when you have given VDD, right, we are considering the case when the V input is VDD. So at that moment, what is the output? It is VOL dash. Okay,
but sir, sir, but
we are not considering this case.
okay.
Sir, but if we give V in as VDD, which is the maximum possible value for logic one,
Right.
then the V out would be the least possible value. If it is at VTH, just below VTH, then for an input value of less than VDD, which is still logic 1, the output shall not be logic 0 anymore.
Output will not be logic zero anymore. Oh, you are saying from this point of view that this, if I take consider this point, we will be in the safer side.
Yeah,
Sir.
means
Yes, sir.
if that is less than VTH, then VOL will surely be less
Will
than
be
VTH VOL
surely
dash.
less than this
Yes,
VTH.
sir.
Okay. Okay.
Exactly, sir.
It's fine. It's fine. Agree with you. But you will see that later on that, really the difference between this point and this point will not be that significant. And again, right, we are considering here VDD as means input as VDD, but as you have rightly mentioned, that we might not really have VDD, right? We might have something less than that, right? So in that case, it will be wiser to consider that the minimum value of this input logic low, which is VIH, right? So I agree with you. So if you consider this VIH, so for that point, you should have a output voltage, which is VOL. So considering this VOL value to be like this would be better compared to this one, because then in this case you will be in a safer side. Right. Okay. Thank you. So we are taking here, I thought I will be able to complete it, but seems not possible today. Resistive load inverter. So here what we are trying to do is that, but before I tell you, let me draw it and then let me tell you. This is V in, this is V out. So remember, this is drain, this is source, this is gate, right? And this is V out, already mentioned. So from here, what we have to do is that we are trying to find all the points, okay, on the VTC. So that means if we this we have a VTC, we are trying to find what is VOH dash. What we are trying to find, what is VOH. We are trying to find corresponding to this, what is VIL. We are trying to find what is VIH. We are trying to find what is the, for this VDD. We are also trying to find these two point, means VOL, VOL dash. We have to find VTH, right? And if we know all this point, we should be also able to find noise margin high and noise margin low, right? Okay. And from our this analysis, we should also be able to say that this slope in the transition region, you might have a plot like this. You might have a plot like this, right? So that means in the transition region, you might have a different slope, right? So this transition region slope, to alter that, what changes you have to make, okay, here, in this design. That is one thing. And here clearly you can see, if it is VDD, the VOL dash, right? These values are also different for these two VTC. So, and also clearly you can see slope is higher. That is better. We want that. And here VOL dash is also lower. We also want that, right? So overall, what we have to change so that our VTC from this, for this particular inverter, will be close enough to that of this ideal VTC of an inverter. You know the ideal VTC of an inverter, right? So what changes we have to do, or what will be the design parameters to get this? To get this type of VTC, right, rather than this type of VTC, right? So we have to start from the MOSFET equation to calculate the or estimate the values of all these points 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then this two will come from this, right? So how to start, but before that, let us also write here the MOSFET equations as a type of recap, right? So MOSFET drain current ID. This is can be written as KN by 2 into VGS minus VTHN square when the MOSFET is in saturation, and the same device will give a current which is equal to Kn into VGS minus VThn minus VDS by 2 into VDS in triode region, right? Just to make a recap, this is the transistor characteristics ID, this is VDS, this region, no, it is not a good drawing, let me, this is even right, this one, and again it is not a good drawing, but you understand, right? I want to mean that this should have, in that case, this, the top plot should have like this, should be like this, right? Like this, not like the previous one that I have drawn, right? Should be like this. So here this region, right, is called the saturation region, and this region, right, is the triode region, right? Okay, and if the transistor has to be operated in this region, then the VDS means the value of VDS has to be greater than VDS sat, right, which is nothing but equal to VGS minus VThn. You know that, all these equations, right? Okay, so if you know all these equations, can you start estimating? First, try to start with these two, VIL and VOH. Yeah, how to start? VIL and VOH. Guys, please tell.
Can we take VIL equals to VThn, then get VOH?
Could you please repeat?
VIL as VThn, no, that would not.
VIL equal to VThn, no, no.
If you write,
so we can take
VGS, right?
VDD minus
RID. VD minus RID. Fine.
It will be V out, right? And ID
will be equal to V out, right?
And we know in terms of VGS and VThn, VGS is basically the VIN, and then we differentiate minus one, right?
Right.
Therefore, there will be a relation.
Right, you are very right. So, okay, but the thing is that, okay, let me start and then ask you. Okay, see, if you have to find this VIL, right, how VIL has been defined in the VTC? VIL is the point where the relation between V out and V in, that is dV out by dV in, is equal to minus one. So, we have to make a relation between the V out and V in, right? And then take a derivative of that and make that equal to minus one and estimate the value of the input voltage. So that will give us this VIL. So that will be the path, right? So for that, you can see if this is the ID, and you know, if this is connected with another, you know, transistor gate as well, then also there is no static current is flowing through this, right? So if this is ID, then same ID is flowing through this. If the same ID is flowing through this, right, then we can obviously say that this V output is equal to VDD minus ID into R, right? V output, that is, this is V output is equal to VDD minus drop across this R. Okay. Now, what is this ID? ID is the current which is flowing through the transistor. So you know that if the transistor is on, obviously in that case, transistor is on because you have gone beyond the threshold voltage. VIL is beyond the threshold voltage. Obviously, VIL is greater than VTHN. It is obvious, right? So in that case, transistor is on. Now the question is, then the transistor will be operating in two of this, either in the saturation region or in the triode region. So which region transistor is operating?
Triode.
Why triode?
Because it has not yet, like the current is just going to start moving.
Yeah, but no, probably you are missing something. Okay. Let us see from this. One second. VDS. Always try to refer to this diagram if you have any doubt. This is the IDVG characteristics, and let us plot the load line here. So this is that load line, right? So this is VDD, right? And this is what will be the value here? Maximum current. You can estimate it from this VDD by R, right? If the drop across VDS is very, very small. This point, right? Okay. Now, initially, you have means you have started increasing your input voltage from zero, and you till the threshold voltage has not reached, the current is zero, right? So till the threshold voltage, suppose the threshold voltage is at 0.5 for this, so you have started from 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, transistor is off, so that means you are on this line only, on this line, right? Off. So now you make 0.6. So 0.6 means you, or maybe 0.7. So 0.7 means you have jumped to, means this, right? The current has just started flowing, right? But see the intersection between this lower, load line and the transistor characteristics. This is this one, right? So obviously the transistor is in the saturation region, right? This is the saturation region, right? So just after coming out from this threshold voltage, the transistor will first go to into the saturation region. Then if you further increase to 0.91 volt, this, make it 0.2 or make it, maybe 2 volt, 3 volt like that, then it will appear like that. And finally, when you go very close to the VDD, then you will be operating in the triode region, right? So if you have any doubt, right, always, draw this VTC, always draw this load line characteristics and understand like the transistor is operating in which region. Then substitute the equation. So here, then if we substitute, it become VDD minus ID. So obviously we understood then it will be in the saturation region. It is KN by 2 into VGS, right? Now this is VGS, right? And here VGS is nothing equal to V in, right? So this is V in minus VTHN that square, right? Into we have a R, right? So then you see this particular equation gives us the relation between output voltage and input voltage. Right. So, and how do you define, how have you defined this VIL? VIL we have defined the point, the input voltage for which the slope is equal to minus one. Slope means dV out by dV in. Right. So, I am not doing the complete thing here. So, you can do it. Right. So, if you now find it here dV out by dv in, do some bit simplification, you will get knr into, I think this is almost no simplification is required, right? It's quite straightforward, right? So this is equal to minus 1, right? Because we are trying to find this VIL, and VIL definition is at VIL slope is minus 1. So here you see everything is known. These are the transistor parameter, this is the resistance value, right? This is the threshold voltage, this is also known. So only unknown is VIN. So from here you can find what is the value of VIN, which is nothing but equal to VIL for this case. And that will be equal to what? That would be equal to VThN plus 1 by KNR. Please check. Is this right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if this is right, so at now at least we have a value of 1 point, which is VIN, right? So we know, this is not the point. This is the point, right? So we have estimated this one, right? So if we now know this value, can you not find VOH? See this relation, right? In this relation, it is saying V out is equal to this. Now here, substitute. VIL here, right? If you substitute here VIL, then you will get VOH, isn't it? So if you know this, you will know this VOH. So let me write that final expression. I am not doing the substitution here, so, but I request you to please do the complete thing of your own. Otherwise, in exam, this type of questions are coming, it would be difficult for you to solve there. These are very easy, but you need to do some practice. This is VDD. 2KNR, right? Okay. So this is the value of VOH. So you understand, you know, I think no need to explain it again and again, what is the value of VOH. It is not the VOH dash, not the maximum value, right? But it is the value of VOH, which is lower than the maximum output voltage, right? So now we know one more point, which is VOH. So we can estimate this point as well. Okay. So, but before I move forward and try to find the other points, let me discuss one more point here with you. That is, you remember that here we had a discussion on this, on the slope in this region, right? Slope in this region. So now, during this region of this particular VTC, this is V out and V in of this particular VTC. So in which mode the transistor is operating? Please tell me.
Saturation.
Obviously saturation. In saturation. It is also clear from here, right? So this mode is also this region is also the transistor is operating in the saturation region. Fine. So this transistor is operating in the saturation region, and we have used the transistor in saturation region here. So the output input relation between V output and V input is the same even in this region. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Do you agree with me that the output between V output and V input is same? Will yes, be sir. Same in this region as well?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then I think you will also agree that this part will also be valid. This part, will also be valid in this region. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Right. It is pretty straightforward, right? We have just taken a derivative here. So if this is, following here, so this is nothing but the slope in this region. So from this, you can clearly see that the slope in this region is dependent on VIN. First, keep this aside. Only consider this part. So then in this region, slope is dependent on this VIN input voltage. That is one thing we understood. Okay. Now, if we say for the same change of VIN for a particular one design to the other design. Okay. Suppose VIN minus VTH, we are considering same range of change. Okay. And we have changed the transistor and this R. Then for the transistor and R, for which this KN into R, this value is higher, we will get a higher slope. Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So from this discussion, at least this part is clear, that if you have to get higher slope in this transition region, then the value of KN into R is expected to be higher. Right? Okay. I want you to please remember or at least keep this in your mind, because when we are discussing this VOL and all these things, this thing will come back to this thing again. Huh? But remember that is for higher slope, higher value of KN R is required. Or maybe we will write from here. I think not much space is also here. For higher slope, higher KN R, this value required. Fine. Okay. So now forget about this slope and now come back again to the estimation of these different points. Okay, so far we have only estimated these two points, right? Now let us try to find this VIH, that is this one, and corresponding to this VIH, we'll have this VOL. Let us try to estimate VIH and VOL, right? But I think for that, it would be nice if we just copy this part. Or which part I should copy? This part? No. I think this part should be fine. Okay, so we have some unwanted things as well. Right. So here, now we are estimating VIH and VOL. Okay. Now, how to start? Same process, right? Again, here also, Vout, because here also you have to use the, this condition that the slope is minus one. So for that, we need to have a relation between Vout and V input. So V output is equal to VDD minus ID into R, right? Okay, now the condition is, in this case, the transistor is operating in which region? Here, the transistor is operating in which region?
Triode
region, because you can see here the change in output voltage, that is very small, in this region, right? And that is only possible when the transistor is operating in the triode region, because here you see, if you now further increase, if you further increase the value of VGS, right, the change in the value of this output voltage or VDS, that is very small, right? So the transistor is operating in here in the triode region. So you need to just write the expression in the triode region, so which is nothing but Kn into VGS is Vin minus threshold voltage minus V out by 2, because and here it was VDS, right? And for this particular case, VDS is nothing but V out. Right? V in is VGS, right? And V output is equal to VDS. So that's why V output we are writing here as this one, right? So this is V output relation with V input, right? So here you can find you have to use this condition, slope is equal to minus one. So for that, what we are doing, we are not trying to find V out in terms of V in, but we will here do in a other way. We will try to find V in terms of V out. Because dv out by dv in is equal to minus 1, so dv in by dv out will also equal to minus 1, right? So we will do that, because you know otherwise we will have a term here like dv out square, right? So dv in, if we dv out here it will be 2, not R. Right. Now you make dv in by dv out. This is equal to minus 1, right? From here, and try to get the derivative out of this, right? And if you finally do it, I request you to please do that and find the value of this V out, right? And find V out. Then that V out is nothing but this VOL, right? If you do that, do a bit simplification, you will get VOL is equal to okay. So it's quite straightforward. From here to here, just do a derivative, make it equal to minus 1, and then just find what is V out. And that V out is nothing but VOL. So that way you will get the value of this VOL, the value of this VOL, right? Okay. Now what about, so now we have find the value of VOL as well. Fine, good. Now we need to find the value of VIH. Then how to estimate the value of VIH? How to get it? So again, you see, we can use this relation, right? Because this is what? This is V in. So if in this V out, you substitute VOL, right? Then you will get VIH. Substitute V out is equal to VOL and find V in, right? And that V in is nothing but VIH, right? So if you do that VIH after that, so you will get VIH will be equal to VThN minus 1 by KNR plus 2 Okay. So please do these small calculations. Okay. And see that you are getting the same thing I am doing. Please let me know if there is something calculation mistake from my side. So then I will be I will rectify that. So now we can also find the value of, we are also able to find the value of VIH. I am saying the value because here these things are like KN, VTHN, KNR, VDD, KNR, these things will be given to you, right? So just substitute that, you can find it, right? So at least these 4 points we know. Now let me ask you this thing. Can you find now the noise margin high? Yes, you should be able to, right? Because noise margin high is nothing but VOH minus VIH. So we know both the points. So you should be able to find what is noise margin high. Noise margin low, similarly, you should be also able to find from here, right? So just substitute this to, you know, this values and which we have already derived, right, in these equations. So that will give you the value of noise margin high and noise margin low, right? And always remember that in general, it is expected that the noise margin high will be equal to the, or closely equal to that of this noise margin low, right? There might be some exceptional case where we intentionally want particular one noise margin bit higher compared to the other side, because suppose in particular situation noise is more prone on okay to the higher side, right? Then we'll try to maximize the noise margin high, but we know that noise will be very low in the lower side. So there we can, if we reduce the noise margin low that side, so we still will be in a safer side. So you can see then from here that this noise margin high and noise margin low, these values also dependent on the device parameters as well as the value of this resistance. So you can choose your own values, right, to you know, tailor the value of noise margin high and noise margin low as per your requirement, right? Okay, so as these 4 points we have already estimated, so let us also try to find these two values, VOH and the VOH dash and VOL dash, right? So in the next page, right, estimate VOL dash and VOH dash, right? Okay. So how do you find VOL dash and VOH dash? Any idea?
Sir, by differentiating to find the minimum and maximum.
Differentiating, but yeah, I understand why you are saying that, but probably you can, you means you know, you are saying because here the slope will be zero, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, but that is true for here, but that is not true for here in the lower side.
So we can give input 0 and VDD.
See, if I ask you to find VOH dash, is it very difficult to find? I guess no, right? Because when this VOH dash is occurring, what is the value of current? VOH is what?
It's almost 0.
When V in is equal to 0. So when V in is equal to 0, transistor is in the off situation.
Off situation.
Right? So then it will be in off situation. So ID is equal to 0. Right? So if ID is equal to 0, V out will be equal to what? V output will be equal to VDD, right? And this is basically equal to VOH dash. So finding VOH dash is very simple for this case. Okay, but what about VOL dash?
So we can write the equation that ID equals to VDD minus VOL upon R. And we can substitute the value of ID to be the expression of saturation current. And then we can get VOL.
Right. I understand your point. So see this. When we are trying to find this VOL dash, that is this point, the transistor is operating in which region? The transistor is operating in which region?
Triode.
You should be able to tell that because we have discussed it so long now.
Triode region, right.
Right, triode region, right. So, right. So, you know, for this triode region, what is the value of current that is flowing through this transistor, right? The same current has to flow through this resistance as well. Right. Okay. So, what I want to mean is that when V output will be equal to VOL dash, when V output is equal to VOL dash, then VDD minus V output, V output is equal to VOL dash by this R, that means the current flowing through this resistor will be equal to the current flowing through this transistor in that, and the transistor is operating in the triode region, right? Here V output or VDS will be equal to VOL dash, right? VOL dash. Do you agree with me on this equation? Do you agree with me on this equation?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if you agree with me on this equation, so you see here all the terms are known except this VOL dash, right? And you will get, obviously you can see, it will get a square term, so quadratic equation, right? You can solve it and you will find the expression of this VOL dash. So I'm just writing that equation here, but I request you to please do it. I have done it completely in my copy, but now if I have to do the same thing, it will take a huge amount of time. So for the sake of time, I'm just writing the final expression. And this is quite straightforward, just substitution, and it should be 2VDD by KNR. But as you know that it will have a, we are having a quadratic equation. So obviously you will have, actually you have a here plus and minus this here, but we are saying that the minus value we should only consider, plus value we should not. I request you to please think about it, why plus value we are discarding. Okay, so please think about it. This is as a homework. Why we are taking the negative sign, right? Okay, now here one interesting thing. See how much time we left? 4 minutes. Okay, I think we will be able to finish. So see this expression of VOL dash. VOL dash is equal to this term, right? And if you see inside this root, we have then same term square minus 2VDD by KN into R, right? Now, this term and this is basically square of this, so they are basically the same thing, right? So if the value of KN R increases, right, what will happen to the value of VOL dash?
Approach
it will reduce, right? Do you agree with me? Okay, so if because see here, these two terms are same, only this, so here it is in the denominator. So if you increase the value of this, so basically you are, these two terms is getting much closer to each other, so VOL dash value has to reduce, right? So that means what it says is that VOL dash, which is this point, and we have also discussed that we should get the value of VOL dash as low as possible, right? Otherwise there is a chance that the next transistor will get turned on, right? And that is possible when we have this KNR value very high, right? And you remember that I think in one or two pages before, we have also discussed that regarding the slope, right? To get the slope higher, we should also make the value of Kn by R, this value, higher, right? So by making the value of Kn into R, this value higher, we are not only getting the slope, we are not only, you know, improving the slope in the transition region, but we are also getting a lower value of VOL dash. Both this condition actually we deserve, right? Or we want, right? So that means if we have this V out, V input, and if we have a VTC for a particular this resistive load inverter like this, right? Then by improving the value of Kn and R, or by increasing the value of Kn and R, you can further increase the value of the slope, as well as you can reduce the, I think, this point is, I am, because it will never reach to zero, right? But maybe close to that zero, right? So you are getting an improvement in this with the value of increasing the value of Kn into R, right? Oh, what happened? 1 minute. So for the, maybe we can also plot to another thing here like this, right? So moral of the story is that for this type of inverter, the value of Kn into R has to be as high as possible, right? Then you will get the desired characteristics, right? Okay, then I think it's already 12. You have some next class. So next class onwards, we will start discussion. We will start our discussion from here, and we'll see why this criteria, that is high value of Kn and R, is difficult to really achieve. Because to get the value of Kn and R higher, you can either make the value of Kn higher or you can make the value of R higher, right? So we'll see the pros and cons of making this this individual term, tweaking this individual term, okay, on the impact of this VTC, as well as the, it will not make any impact on the VTC, because the Kn into R value is constant, but it will impact in terms of fabrication delay, switching characteristics, all this stuff. So that part we'll discuss in the next class. Okay, then I am stop recording this part.